No, you're not confused. You saw the title right. Not only was it a huge debate who would go number 3 overall to the Niners, but it was widely debated who was going to be the best rookie in this year's draft class, as there was 5 taken in the top 15. And that isn't even a discussion anymore. Mac Jones is clearly the best rookie this year so far, but not only that, there's an actual debate that he is having the best rookie season of any quarterback in NFL history, and we are going to make that debate today. Now, I want to give a precedent as to why I think this. First of all, when we look at most rookies or backups in that case, they have the advantage on the defense not knowing how to play them. We get guys like Derek Anderson, RG3, Kaepernick, all players who were incredible out from the jump, but seemed to plateau or decline once defenses got more fit and learn the best strategies on how to play them. Injuries play a factor too, but we see this a lot, maybe most recently in Mike White on a smaller game size scale. However, with Mac Jones, I see the complete opposite. He is the one figuring out the defenses, and the more he plays, the better understanding of fronts, blitzes, coverages, and matchups he has, and he only continues to look better and better as the weeks go on. Now, as I'm making this video, I'm realizing it's a little bit longer of a video, so I just kind of want to structure it so I don't get confused, so you guys don't get confused. So first, we're going to go into a film analysis and break down a lot of film. There's going to be 3 parts to that, because first, we need to build a case of why or how Mac Jones is so good. So we're going to get a better understanding of that, and then after the film analysis, we're going to talk about some quarterbacks that had the best rookie seasons in NFL history, and then see where Mac Jones compares and make our predictions of where we think he's going to end up as this season, and then seasons moving forward. This is going to be a ton of fun. It's a longer video. There's so much to talk about, so stick around and let's get into it. So looking at Mac Jones' film, the first thing we have to look at in this category is his pocket presence, because he already has a veteran level of pocket presence. So let's just get into this first play, because there are some things he did really, really well in this play, but some things I didn't like as well. So first, this is going to be a play action play. The first thing I really don't like about this is how long he takes to turn around. I mean, I get selling a good play action can be very important, but this isn't Alabama anymore. You're not going to have all this time in the world. Just from here to hear how long this takes, the defense could have completely changed coverage. You're not going to be at the advantageous spot because you're not looking at receivers are downfield, see if they're winning their matchups or where the defense is. But anyways, continuing on, this guy gets absolutely beat right here, and this is going to be a sack if he doesn't move. And the idea is you want to make little micro side steps, step up in the pocket, step back in the pocket, slide right, slide left. But right when a guy is coming right after you, you have to do things a lot more extreme. That's exactly what Mac Jones does. Absolutely turns on the brakes, turns off the boners, looks up field. He's not going to set and throw because he sees all this green grass right in front of him. He takes off. He's not going to be known to do this, but he did have not that bad of a 40 time. I think he ran like a 4.8, so he can get this done. On this play, he does pick up the first down. So again, really, really love his pocket presence here, avoiding the pressure, and I absolutely love. And it's not always going to be this tiny step. Sometimes you need to make a big side step, and he can take off and run. So this play right here, we're just going to look at this angle just to see the whole formation of the defense, because right now we need to know where we're going pre-snap. Right now we see a single high safety, we see Kendrick Bourne in press man coverage, so we are going to like this matchup best. He's going to be an outside fade release, so right away this is going to be our number one target, so that's what we're looking for pre-snap. So as long as we know that moving forward, that's what we like. So having that in mind, all these quarterback coaches and people will tell you, you have to have a shot clock in your head. Around 2.5 seconds of when you're gonna get the ball out, maybe 3 seconds. I just don't think that's all true, because if you have a shot clock in your head, that really gives you a false sense of security or panic, because sometimes you're going to have 5-6 seconds in the pocket and you need to be calm and be aware and just feel the pressure and be able to stand in there, not after 3 seconds thinking, okay, my shot clock's done, let's panic and freak out. And sometimes it's going to be even less than that. So let's take a look at this play here. So paying attention to the right tackle right now, this is where this comes in, because not even a second into this play, he absolutely gets burned off the line, and he's in Mac Jones's face within a second. So this 2.5 second, 3 second shot clock just is no good. You have to be ready. You have to know what your first read is, and Mac Jones absolutely knows where it's at. So watch this full speed, how quick he gets this out, and this ends up being a touchdown on this play. That is insane. His pocket presence, he doesn't have a shot clock in his head. He was just ready and willing to react to whatever, and is able to take 1, 2, didn't even barely got his 3-step drop in. He's already making his throw off his back foot. So impressive. I cannot believe this guy is a rookie quarterback. Now this is going to be the complete other end of the spectrum. When you have more time than you thought, you're going to need to be able to stand there and realize you have more time, because I've seen people in the past like Baker Mayfield, once he kind of hits that 3 second mark, he's looking to scramble, he's looking to get out of the pocket because he feels like there should be pressure there, even if it's phantom pressure and it's actually not. So the Patriots offensive line as the season has gone on has gotten much healthier, gave them a much cleaner pocket than they did at the beginning of the year when they were dealing with a lot of injuries. But the way this pocket sets up is just so beautiful, which is good because he does have some underneath routes, but he did pre-snap see that he is going to have a really, really favorable matchup if the long route can develop, which it does. We do see pressure right here, and like I said, it's not always, you don't need to reverse spin out or do anything huge. So this, he just makes this couple step up, steps right into the throw, and delivers an absolute strike. Now on this play, the offensive line completely messes up. So Damian Harris is going to go on a little swing pass out to the right. But right now we have a man blocked right here, here, and then here on the outside, here, which leaves Devin White one-on-one with the center. The center for some reason completely goes for this double team, leaves Devin White free, wide open on the blitz. And I don't know if I'm about you, if I see Devin White, someone who runs like a 4-3, 4-4 coming straight at me, that is absolutely terrifying. But in the NFL, these things are going to happen, so you have to be ready for this. As a rookie quarterback, this isn't going to be too fun, but luckily for us, Mac Jones is very much a veteran. So just look at the complete brain fart by the center here. I mean, you have a guy running right at you. I mean, what are you doing? Mac Jones sees this immediately. He's probably like, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. Doesn't, I mean, you have to, you cannot do, like we said before, if someone's coming straight at you, you can't do these little movements. It is going to be a sack. So he gets out of the pocket, but doesn't panic, keeps his eyes downfield, is about to take the sack, but sees Damian Harris, is able to get away from the pressure. Right here, you have to make a decision. So right around here, you're either going to see, if you're going to get sacked, just throw it at Damian Harris's feet. You're not going to be able to get an off an accurate pass. It's going to be a tip. This is where a lot of interceptions happen, trying to make stuff happen that just isn't there. Take your loss. Just go to the dirt. You just know your offensive line messed up. Live to live another play. But right here, once he gets away from him, he knows he can complete this pass, and he does. And luckily for Mac Jones, Damian Harris is an absolute beast of a receiving back. So he takes this almost nothing play, this is going to be a huge sack, into a positive gain. Right again, you just see this is so impressive how he was able to handle the pressure. He just never looks frazzled out there, always looks like he knows what he's doing. It looks like he's a step ahead of the defense, not behind, which you just again don't see from rookies. That's why he's in our discussion for one of the best rookies of all time. Now the next part of our film analysis is all going to be about reading defenses, and first play we're going to look at is the Miami Dolphins. This absolutely destroyed the Ravens' Lamar Jackson. Right now they're in obvious man coverage, or it's going to be a cover one robber, so we're man, and then this is the matchup right here, here on James White, and this is going to be a cover one robber, so he's just kind of going to lurk the middle of the field. But Mac Jones knows all of this, and he reads this pre-snap, and so he makes his adjustment. He knows where he wants to go with the lead. You just see he knows where he's going to go with the ball pre-snap. He's not even really, and with man coverage, you really don't have to look off any safeties in particularly. I mean, maybe it helps a little bit, but when you're in this kind of press man, you can kind of just see this beautiful, beautiful play. Now this is going to be another cover one robber concept that we're going to look at with the Patriots, and Mac Jones, I have no idea how he knew or saw this, but this is just another highly, highly impressive read. Right now he sees this, he probably has a few things in mind on what he thinks his wide receivers get off the line, but not everything goes to plan, so this is going to be a play action. He knows all the routes in his head beforehand, and look at right here, as the pressure is getting right to his face, the pocket's closing in on him, look at all the wide receivers downfield, who's going to be open? We look here, there's really no separation. Here, absolutely no separation. Here, this is the cover one robber, so they're kind of, this is absolutely taken away. He's not even looking at him. He's ready to throw the ball. So where does Mac Jones go with this ball? He knew he had a running back in the outlet or in the flats that was going to be waiting for him. Knew that it was going to be cover one, so he was going to have a linebacker on him, and is able to make this absolutely incredible read and throw, and able to flip it out to his running back. And I mean, this is really, really tight, but he knows his running back has the step on him, and he's going to be much faster, and he's able to get this up, get it out to his running back. Very accurate, so he can keep running after the ball and pick up the first down on what it looks like should have been a nothing play, or at the best a sack. And for this play and a couple of other plays, for some reason I couldn't find it on the All 22. They had them all there, and I saw the play and everything and just wouldn't let me watch it. I don't know if someone has a fucking NFT on these plays, that's why I can't see it, but nonetheless, we're gonna have to watch the broadcast version, so I hope that's okay. But what you didn't see about this play is this: the Cleveland defense comes in this double mug lip, both linebackers in the A gap, and so right now you have to be ready. That does not mean they're gonna bring the pressure, but if you're not ready, if they do send the pressure, then you are going to be screwed. So Mac Jones on this play, he makes a check at the line, completely switches the play, he audibles the tight end across the field, so we're leaving 3-by-1 set. And so now on the bottom of our screen, this is going to be the matchup. We see the safety is nowhere in position to help, so Mac Jones does all of this pre-snap and then is able to make this absolute strike. They don't end up sending the pressure, but regardless, this play was the right play. He called the open, and it was absolutely beautiful. And I just want to mention that this was a little bit more of the more complicated plays where he's reading the defense's pre-snap because he already has such a high level, and I could show you a million examples because in a lot of these games he's dinking and dunking down the field. But to me, that's being prepared, that's knowing what the defense is giving you, that's making the correct change. And even if it's audible into a run, it's not even going to show up on Mac Jones's stat sheet, but if there is a pass that he sees that is going to have no chance of success, he is very, very willing and often calls it and checks it to a run play. And after successful runs, that should be credited to Mac Jones. If you just put on a Patriots game and you see him just dissecting defenses, making all the calls, making the line changes, changing the protection up front, it is just so, so impressive. So I only showed a few plays of like more some of the more calculated and advanced things that he does before the line, but on any given play, he is doing so much for this offense already as a rookie, which is a very, very veteran level thing that some veterans don't even do up until this point. And the third part of the film analysis that we're going to look at is accuracy with Mac Jones. And this play is so, so incredibly beautiful. I don't know if you guys have seen this play before, but this is where football just becomes art. And okay, so let me set the stage. The Browns are in a cover two defense, but they're gonna run this double post route, and this is where you can kind of manipulate zones to make them man. So we're gonna have these double posts, and just based off these posts, that's gonna take the attention of this safety and this safety. So even though it's cover two, we're gonna have a flag with this tight end right here, a corner route, and that's going to be the man-to-man route. So that's what we're targeting, that's how this play is schemed up. So now it's time to execute. Just watch this throw. This is so incredibly beautiful. So as we watch this develop, you're going to see up top the two double posts start to develop. Going to take both of the safeties off, and it's going to be a man coverage. Look where he's throwing this ball. On the far right hash, he's going to throw this ball right now. And I want to add some of these plays in. And I mean, I didn't want to talk about the short dinking and dunking kind of accuracy, because any decent varsity quarterback can throw an accurate slant or hitch. But these plays, especially with Mac Jones' criticism being his deep ball accuracy and some of his arm power going into the draft, throws like these make me so happy. Kind of hard to see the ball right now. But look where this ball lands. Look at the coverage on this. I mean, this play was schemed open, but look at where this ball placement is. That is absolutely beautiful. He went insane in this game. We're gonna watch this full speed right now. He went absolutely insane in this Brown game. He's made so, so many amazing throws, and this is probably the best one of his entire season so far. Just look at the placement on this. That is beautiful. So in this cover one play, it's gonna be really tricky because it's gonna put the safety in a really difficult spot, and the safety actually chooses correctly on this play. At the top of the screen right here, we're gonna have like this post or deep over route, trying to draw the safety because we have Kendrick Bourne right here trying to go up the seam to get the touchdown. This is what Mac Jones' read is. This is what he calls, chooses. And so what we have to do is make the right read and make the throw. But when this comes down, the safety actually chooses right. He doesn't fully commit yet. He's reading Mac Jones' eyes, so Mac Jones doesn't completely lead him away because this post route should be more open if he comes back to it. But he still thinks he can make this throw. And this is where you have to be highly, highly accurate. He's already let it go, and this is going to be a very sketchy window. But this is where accuracy comes in. You can get away with these types of throws. Look at where the ball is coming in at, and look how tight this window is getting. But put it up in a way, avoid the huge hit from the safety, put it in a spot where it's not going to get only intercepted, where only his receiver can get it. This throw was absolutely beautiful, resulting in the touchdown. And we're going to watch this full speed really quick. But Mac Jones seems to make two or three of these throws of games where it's absolutely unreal that he is a rookie, trusting his arm, trusting his receiver to put it where only they can get it, and they often come down and make it. So you see all this dinking and dunking, and you really applaud him for being that smart, but then you can also pull off stuff like this. This is why he is so hard to stop and why they've been on a 6 or 7 game winning streak. So this play is just more of attention to detail that you really don't see from rookies that Mac Jones has displayed on a weekly basis. Again, this linebacker is going to have the running back coming out of the flats, and we're going to do like a little wheel route up the sideline. And this is the difference between accurate and non-accurate on this play, is the difference between a first down and a pick six. I'll show you what I mean. As we get this play started, we're going to see the running back come out, start to come up the field. Mac Jones is throwing it right now, and if he leads him up the field like you think he should, this is going to be a pick six. I'll show you what I mean. It looks like the linebacker is so out of position, but as he's throwing it, the people in the NFL are much, much, much faster. And this is where I see a lot of pick sixes thrown as rookies, because they're just not expecting them to cover that much ground that fast. But as the ball's coming in, Look at the running back caught it right there. Look at where the linebacker is. If he's throwing him upfield like he should, or most people would, if he's throwing upfield, the linebacker's going to undercut this and this is going to be a pick six. Mac Jones throws it back shoulder. He catches it right here, back shoulder. This is going to be a pick. Just to throw it back shoulder on a wheel route when you think, when it looks wide open when you're throwing it, is the attention to detail that Mac Jones brings to the Patriots that is just so impressive. And we won't spend too long on this one because this one is very, very similar to the Browns one. Again, it's going to be another seam right here against cover one. The Patriots are always going to run this. They've done it with Gronk and Brady and Belichick for a million years. So we're just going to throw this full speed. Again, putting it right over the top. And he's not going to throw it on a rope. He's going to throw it with a ton of touch. It's going to get right past the defender, right before the safety where only his person can get it. And he's going to avoid the major hit as well. Another beautiful, beautiful throw from Mac Jones. Brady, Belichick, they've been doing that for so long. Gronkowski. I mean, just to see Mac Jones doing it right away in his rookie year is just so unfair to the rest of the NFL. And another combination of reading the defense beforehand and accuracy, this is going to be against the Jets. Just take a three-step drop, know where you're going with the ball, put it, I mean, how much better than that does it get? I mean, not only does he have like a step on him, he is completely covered. And the receiver doesn't even have to go up and moss him. It's just the ball placement on this is so, it couldn't get any better than that. And I just threw this one in the preseason just because I've shown a lot of plays and he's really not throwing it on a rope, but this play he can throw it on the rope because people question Mac Jones's arm strength a lot. And of course he doesn't have a Josh Allen, but if Josh Allen is the level that we're comparing everyone to, that's just going to be unfair. Can he make every single throw? Yes, we've seen Mac Jones being able to use his mind to be able to put up a perfect ball placement, but sometimes the windows are going to be really tight. Sometimes you need to step up there and just fucking rope it in there. But I love that throw so much because it was with all the doubters in there saying he had a weak arm and everything. He has pressure right on him. I mean, he even gets hit like right before he throws this right here. He gets bumped off his spot just still a bit. Oh, all right, there's a tight window, let me just rope that in there. Absolutely love this play. So now that we've gotten a chance to look at a bunch of film, let's look at some numbers. As of right now, Mac Jones is on pace to throw for over 4,000 yards, over 22 touchdowns, and have a completion percentage over 70%. He has also averaged 120 passer rating in his last three games, and like I mentioned before, he only seems to figure out defenses more and more, and so we can only assume as the season continues, he's going to get much better. And all his remaining games are absolutely perfect. He is going to have a huge opportunity to get some big staples wins, and then some easy wins to pad the stats. They play the Bills in Buffalo, then the Colts in Indy. Two huge staple wins if he can get it done. And then they host the Bills in Foxborough, and then they host the Jaguars, and then they will attempt to bookmark their season with a revenge win against the Dolphins. Now let's talk about the best rookie seasons of all time. I don't want to rank them, but here are some I picked to compare. The first one we're going to talk about is Dan Marino. He had a 58.4% completion percentage, 2,210 yards, 20 touchdowns, 6 interceptions. He only got 9 starts, but once he was put in, he proved to be the man in the next franchise quarterback for the Dolphins. And same goes for Russell Wilson. Now we can start looking at his record because the Seahawks went 11-5 and also had a very good team. Russell Wilson passed for 3,100 yards, 26 passing touchdowns, 10 interceptions, and 4 rushing touchdowns. The next person we're going to look at is Dak Prescott, who had a fantastic rookie year with that amazing offensive line and Zeke Elliott. He had a 67% completion percentage. He threw for over 3,600 yards, 23 passing touchdowns, 6 rushing touchdowns, and they finished with a 13-3 record. Now, one of the most impressive, maybe not the most impressive statistically, but Big Ben Roethlisberger went 13-0 as a starter in the regular season and ended up going 15-1 in his rookie year. And the team was deemed the franchise quarterback from his rookie year. He passed for 66%, 2,621 yards, 17 passing touchdowns, and 11 interceptions. And the last one we're going to get is more of an honorable mention, but is RG3. He was an absolute monster, took over immediately, threw for 65%, 3,200 passing yards, 20 touchdowns, 815 rushing yards, and 7 touchdowns. Not going to look at the record on this one because that's more of a team stat, and RG3 is on a much worse team. Now we put Mac Jones into this list, and we can start to see how fitting his season compares to all the other all-time great rookies. Not only that, with these Hall of Fame quarterbacks as well, we see traits that remind me a lot of Mac Jones, like Big Ben, Dan Marino, Dak Prescott, quarterbacks having success because of their understanding of the defenses, their arm talent, and wildly accurate passing attack. And like Big Ben and Dak, who are also a part of very good teams like Mac Jones, they have been able to take over the franchise successfully and never look back. So to see that Mac Jones is only improving week to week, if he finishes with over 70% completion percentage, over 22 touchdowns, single digit interceptions, carrying a team with 17 starts who started the season 1-4 to a playoff berth and maybe even a playoff win, Mac Jones is going to be looked at as one of, if not the best rookie quarterbacks of all time. And when we watch film like we did, it is not all that hard to see why. Now, if you've made it to this point in the video, you're actually insane. So I'm going to say something that's a little insane. Doesn't give you, I mean, if you've seen on HBO series, Tom Brady's Man in the Arena, if you saw episode one, isn't this a little reminiscent of what we're seeing right now? I mean, Drew Bledsoe goes down, Tom Brady comes in, kills it, takes over the team, Cam Newton, MVP, Mac Jones takes it over. I don't know. I mean, I could be insane. I don't even want to say something like this, but if we are watching a documentary in 20 years from now, and this is episode one, this is really fucking cool. But let me know what you guys think. I know this is a crazy idea and a lot of pressure to put on someone, but it's not like predicting anything. Mac Jones, we've seen him do it. We watched all the film. He is very, very capable of doing everything. I've just been so highly impressed, I think, along with a lot of people on this boat. I'm just so incredibly impressed with him, and I think it is a very good possibility that we look at him as one of the best rookie quarterbacks of all time, and he is in the perfect situation, the perfect system. He has Belichick and McDaniels, and as long as he's going to be there, he is so, so smart. He has all the tools to be an amazing quarterback for years and years to come. But let me know what you guys think. Make sure to like this video if you like videos like these. Make sure to subscribe if you enjoy daily sports content. Comment down below what you think of Mac Jones. Thank you guys so much for checking out the channel. I appreciate y'all so much. I know this is a little bit longer of a video. As I'm kind of planning this out, I think it's going to be, yeah, one of my longer videos. So let me know if you like this longer style or if you like the short, brief, choppy ones. Let me know what you think. Thank you guys so much for checking out the channel. I will see you all tomorrow. Peace.